You know me as the host of the Too Busy to Eat show, but I'm also founder and CEO of Too Busy to Eat, the protein bar company. I make what I feel is the healthiest and best tasting protein bar on the market. So now that came from, it developed from my own frustration of not being able to find a bar that that tasted good and that was extremely healthy that I could have maybe multiple times a day if I was really busy, or I could feed my kids and not feel guilty about what they ate. So I created this bar with grass-fed whey protein, no more than 3 grams of sugar, which is all naturally occurring, and it's gluten-free, non-GMO, the list goes on. So don't take my word for it, I want you to try them. And I want to give you incentive to try them. So I'm going to give you 20% off your first order. You can get a sample bag of bars, or you can get a whole box, whatever you want. Go to my website, toobusytoeat.com. Not hard to remember. Show the company. And enter the promo code TBTEshow. TBTEshow. Actually, it's a discount box when you check out. And you get 20% off your first order, no matter how small or large. So go to the website now, try them out, and then let me know what you think. Welcome to Too Busy to Eat. Today, we have Sophie Jaffe on the show. Man, Sophie is a health and wellness expert. She's our certified raw food chef. She is a yoga instructor. She's also a personal trainer, and she was a personal chef for George Clooney. Very cool. Besides being a mom and a wife and being a very family-oriented person, she has an amazing business called Philosophie. And the way it's spelled, Philosophie, you'll get it in a second. The company is fantastic. She provides superfood blends and has these cleanse programs that have been affecting people positively in their health worldwide. And it's just a great, great product. Her philosophy behind the product is just rock solid. Now, to get more information about her, you go to philosophie.com. It's P-H-I-L-O, and then it's S-O-P-H-I-E.com. That's why it's special, because it ends with her name. It's pretty cool. So let's get to the show. So, Sophie, I'm so excited to have you on the show. Thanks for taking time on your busy schedule to be here.
Yes, thanks for having me.
This is great. So, you know, like I mentioned already, I've been excited to read about the things you've been doing, the things you've created. So why don't you give us a little background, tell us how you got to where you are today.
Sure. So I kind of fell in love with healthy living, raw foods in my early 20s. So I'm 32 now. I was about 20, 21. And I started working at a juice bar in Hollywood, and I just wanted a couple extra hours of work. I was hanging out there a lot anyway. And I was like, you know what? Why don't I work here? I'm already here anyway, all the time, hanging out, asking questions, reading their books, looking at all these natural modalities for healing. Right. I was already there anyway. So do you guys have, 5 or 6 hour shifts for me to work? I'm like, yeah, sure. That's all we really have, actually. Right. And then basically that small little shift turn into me working full time. I started managing the company. After managing the company, we started these group cleanse programs, but the cleanse programs were focused on food based cleansing, actually chewing your food and getting plenty of fiber and protein, right. All the nutrients that you need to help your body cleanse efficiently. And then at that point, I was 23 or so and had been working for someone else for, 50, 60 hour weeks. And I was kind of working myself to the bone, but I joked that I had my PhD in raw foods because learned so much in those years. But I was just kind of, I reached my point where I was like, I don't really need to be working for someone else. I should be working for myself.
Yes.
So, I broke away, started Philosophie. Yeah. My best friend from childhood's mom created the name. She would got off the plane. She knew I was looking for a good name, and she kind of does this. She's a lawyer, but she does branding for companies.
Sure, right.
She got off a plane. She's known me since I was 3.
And oh gosh,
you ready for this name? Sit down. It's so good. It's like philosophy spelled with your name. And I was that's awesome. That's it.
Perfect.
So good. Just know me since I was in diapers.
That's really cool.
And that's kind of like the embodiment of everything I'm trying to do. I'm a yoga instructor. I'm a personal trainer now. I have all these programs. I have superfood line. Like that is it's mind, body, soul. Now I'm a mama. Like, where does the mama stuff come in? And mindfulness and nutrition, all of that kind of culminating into this one philosophy and under this one umbrella of just wellness.
Right.
So that's where it started. And then I started philosophy. And at that point, I was making group cleanses and kind of privately one-on-one with clients instead of doing big group ones. I mean, I did that for a while too. From the group cleanse situation, I kind of, there were a couple of years there where I was just kind of crazy and working myself to the bone. I had a commercial kitchen.
Oh gosh. And
I was delivering food to Air One, which is like a local health food store.
Yeah. Okay.
I was making all their pre-made foods. So their smoothies, their salad.
Right.
I was delivering that. That was before they even had a to-go menu. I was that.
You were the to-go menu.
I was the to-go menu. And we delivered three times a week. I was George Clooney's private chef for 8 months during time. That's so I was working for George Clooney 3 days a week. I was delivering food from my commercial kitchen 3 days a week.
Right.
I was pregnant with my second child.
Oh, gosh.
And just kind of both ends burning and really. And I was 28, I guess, at that point.
Okay.
Or 27. And it was just kind of like, how long can I sustain this? You know, like, is this sustainable? And my cleaning lady's daughter. Hi.
Hi.
That's great. Yeah. So it was kind of like, is this sustainable?
Right.
Not
right.
really. You know, and my husband was the one that was like, are you just going to do this forever? Like, you're just going to always be like running around and being in people's kitchens and like to what point? Like you're just worked 14 hour days with when the next baby comes. And so at that point I already had the superfood blends in my clients' kitchens. Okay. So I would make that for them. I would be like, this is your green powder.
Right.
Every time you make a smoothie or make a soup, add a scoop of this to whatever it is you're making. It won't change the flavor too much. You're going to get all these nutrients, protein. It's going to be really cleansing. Berry, chocolate, same thing. Big containers, big scoop, you know, or a tablespoon worth in each one. And that was like their homework. It was like every time you make oatmeal on your own, you add a scoop of this. Right. Every time you make a smoothie, you add a scoop of this.
Right.
So we were like, why don't we just pack those and sell them?
Right, right.
So we did. So we started to sell them and find the ingredients. Yeah. But at that point, I didn't really know how it worked. So I just would go to Air One and buy tocotrienol. Seeds, and I'd mix it all up in this formulation and sell it for $200 a pound and you know, because that's how much it cost me. And I wasn't even making money on it. It was just like, here's your convenience of like this perfect recipe with no added sugar, tons of protein, no soy.
Yeah.
And that of course isn't sustainable. So from there we started getting bulk ingredients.
And
we're like, now where do we store all this stuff? So we just kind of grew organically on its own. And the product line was then, you know, it evolved and it was developed then. And then it just evolved from there and had its growth.
That is fantastic. So it did, I mean, literally started, well, it started in your kitchen and other people in George Clooney's kitchen too. Yeah. And all the people. And that's where it got going. Now, so you work, how was that? That's just a side note, really. Yeah. But how was it working with George Clooney? He's one of my favorite guys.
He's amazing. He's amazing. Yeah. He's so genuine and so kind and so good-hearted. And just like, he's like a guy's guy. You know, like he's just like a good guy. And like,
it's funny how you can, even in acting, that comes across. Yeah.
You can tell.
Yeah. Like, I like that guy. Yeah.
I was shocked. Like 6 months later, I'm like, still a good guy. Like, three days a week. Like he's in his own home. He doesn't have to be nice to me. His true colors can come out, you know?
Right.
Like,
yeah.
But like the way he's had phone calls, the way he just was a very good person. You could feel that.
Cool. Yeah. That is so cool.
And it's nice that he got that big and he can still hold on.
Yes. Yes.
Humble,
maintain. Yeah.
Good nature.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. And keep your all those basics down there. So the process was, you're also a certified raw food chef. I was looking at that. Now, was that part of the process as you were working at the juice managing?
Yeah. Well, when I left the juice bar, I was like, ooh, I probably should have some credentials. People are going to ask, I'm not working under like this other thing anymore. Yeah. So then I became a raw food chef along with that came like raw food nutrition.
Yeah,
and
then
I took a bunch of like classes cause I wanted, that was like an online program. And I was like, I want to do some one-on-one stuff. And person. So Matthew Kinney has a raw food place in Santa Monica. Okay. So I did some classes with him, and just kind of taking classes all over the world. Like when I was in Thailand, took more and just continued to strengthen it. And then along the same time, I was doing my yoga teacher training. And I feel like it all kind of just goes together in terms of wellness and just,
No, it does. It's a neat journey that you are on to get to where you are.
Yeah.
Now, I definitely want to talk about the products because I'm fascinated about what you have, but I want to ask you like this, you know, you have so many things going on. You have a family, you've got this business, your yoga and personal training. How do you, what's the key to balancing that for you? Your fitness, nutrition, business, family, how do you manage it all?
I mean, it's that in itself is a part-time job is like scheduling, having a tribe of support, like feeling supported is really important because if I don't feel supported by my community, by my husband, by my assistant, if I start to feel like, whoa, I'm not supported. I'm doing this all on my own and I'm supporting all of you and all of this stuff. And I've created this empire in terms of like, I have babies running around being mini-me's and needing from me. And I have this, you know, all these employees and I have all of my philosophy tribe and I'm maintaining this energy. Like I need support.
Yes.
And so it's really important. I mean, it's hard for me to ask for what I need.
Right.
So it's moving into my early 30s. That's been like the biggest thing is being really careful with my time and energy and who I spend it with.
Yeah.
Because especially with having kids, that energy is so just magical and it's easy to let it drain you. It's easy to bring on other people's energies. So I spend a lot of time at home when I'm in town.
Yeah.
I like to be in my pajamas or yoga clothes at home working, kind of just filling up with that homebody kind of experience.
Yeah.
Hold on one second. Alex, can you take this toy away from her? she's like playing with a Halloween toy and it's like screaming in the background.
I can't hear it. So that's good.
Okay, but
that's
fine. Good.
I love it.
Like, distracting. It's literally like a yelling.
Oh my gosh.
Halloween toy.
we're peeking into your life right now.
Exactly.
This is
awesome. Exactly. And my kids aren't even home. That's the thing. Like, this is normal. We've got the dog, my assistant, cleaning lady, her daughter, her other baby, my two kids, my husband, like friends.
Oh my gosh.
It's always like, I love chaos, I love good energy being like in the home. I'm a very loving person and I like sharing that, you know, and I don't want to like seclude. I live a very blessed life and I want to bring as many people into that as possible as long as they kind of earn that.
Yeah, right.
And it keeps me balanced to have that.
No, it's great. I mean, it's with all the things you do, that's the personality. You have to have that personality to make it work.
Yeah.
You know?
And I enjoy it. Like it's chaos to some people, but to me, it's like organized chaos. It's I enjoy it. Come here, Luca. I enjoy it. I enjoy giving and nurturing others, but I also, it nurtures me back.
Right. Right.
Like having that, you know. But also I think in terms of balance, I think it's just really important to take time to schedule self-care. So I'll put like my favorite yoga class, I'll put it into my schedule a week ahead of time or else it just won't happen.
Right.
It just won't happen because I need a babysitter if I want to go to the, or my husband needs to take the kids or, you know, and so then I'll have my friends go to class. So it's like more of an experience. And like, if I'm doing a meeting, I'll have a meeting on the phone or with someone else if I can, like while I'm hiking or while I'm walking.
Yes.
Then I'm like taking care of myself, my body, and, you know, letting go of that kind of energy that gets pent up by sitting all the time, like doing this kind of stuff and working on my computer or standing in the kitchen.
Right.
And it just, I always just find ways to kind of balance it in that way, but it's hard. It's a very conscious effort to not let my phone take over my life.
And, sure.
You know, I have to put my phone on airplane mode at 9:30 every night or I'll be on doing work till midnight. And then oh, midnight. Now I have to wait. The kids are going to wake me up at 6, whether I like it or not.
Right.
I have a choice. Like I don't get to just sleep in because I went to bed late, you know? So I have to cut my husband and I both like have an agreement at 9:30 every night to shut our phones
down. Yeah.
And it's really nice. It's a great treat. It's like goodbye world. Like I'm going to take care of myself. Yeah.
It's the disconnected times. It was just, I mean, you're so connected. We're so connected nowadays to take that planned disconnected times was really important for your mental and physical health, really.
Yeah. And I've now extended it. So I usually charge my phone down. So we just moved into a new home.
Okay.
And I think like with new beginnings in that way, it also is fall. It's a new season.
Yeah.
I keep my phone downstairs to charge it now, or away in the bathroom, so away smart. From my bedroom, so that it's not constantly reminding me that it's there. And when I wake up in the morning, the first thing I do isn't to open up my phone. It's still on airplane mode, and I try and keep it there until I take my kids to school.
Right.
Now it extends that sacred time even longer. And then when I go to start my day, I'm ready because I've had so much time for myself to fill up that space with like goodness.
Yeah. And you're present with your kids. You're present with your husband. You're there and you're not distracted. And that's really valuable. It pays off in the long run just with the relationship.
It does. And in terms of stress, like if I started my day by looking at my phone every morning, the weight of the world I would feel that because I do have way too much on my plate if most people looked at it, but it's manageable for me as long as I take these little things that I know I need to balance it.
Yeah, absolutely. That's great. So, I mean, really you've done so much and you got a lot going on. Let's talk some about your superfood blends and your cleanses. Why don't you start, give us a little bit insight on right now what you have for your superfoods.
Yeah.
And how you mentioned a little bit already, but how that is used, because your one of your lines is make every food a superfood, which I love, but tell us about that.
Yeah. Sure. So we have three different powders or three different flavors. That translates to the powders, the coconut butters, and the honeys.
Okay.
So there's a green one, a chocolate one, and a berry one.
Okay.
They each serve kind of different purposes in like synergistic ways.
Right.
So they're all, the commonalities are that they're all high in antioxidants.
Okay.
They're all very cleansing and they all have high protein.
Okay.
Without soy, and they're all no sugar or sugar.
Right.
So all of those things make them kind of unique, because usually out there, there's like a protein powder, but that doesn't mean that it also has antioxidants and superfood.
Right.
Or you may have a superfood blend, but that doesn't mean it's high in protein.
Right.
So it's combining both of those worlds, and it's great for convenience.
Sure.
If you're like, I want to be a healthier person. Right. I want to make every food a superfood, but I don't have the time to like add all these jars to things.
Right. Right. Like and what to add.
How much and when. And so this makes it just easier. Like I'm making a chocolate smoothie, or I'm making a coffee elixir. I want to just add some cacao magic to it. And then you've got so there, the difference is that there's some ingredients that vary between them. So the berry one is the highest in antioxidants.
Okay.
It's really high in vitamin C.
Right.
So it's great for your immune system to prevent getting sick. It has camu in it, which is the highest vitamin C rich fruit on the planet.
Okay.
Along with pomegranate and mangosteen and goji and all these other beautiful things. And then it has a sprouted brown rice protein as the base.
Okay.
So it's not just a brown rice protein. It's a sprouted brown rice.
Right. To another level. Yeah.
And it has more protein and less carbs when it's sprouted.
Right.
So that's the berry one. And that one I like to add to like a salad dressing. I add it to my oatmeal. We just did overnight oats last night and we added the berry bliss to it.
Right.
And it just kind of enhances a dish. It doesn't, none of these take over or have a chalky flavor. Right. They're used to like actually enhance a dish. And then obviously for berry smoothies and acai bowls, it's perfect. Right.
Oh yeah. That's great.
It's perfect. And then, for the cacao magic, that one is like, first of all, I have an enormous sweet tooth. Love to make healthier versions of things like that I normally would eat, the not so healthy version. So I'm always making raw ice creams. I make raw desserts. I'm making raw pies. I'm making like raw cookies, like all kinds of like truffles. And it's just constantly, I have like my fridge stocked with these healthy options so that I grab that first. And they always have the superfoods added to them.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's basically the rundown. The green one has spirulina and hemp and chia seeds. And then the cacao has reishi mushroom and chia seeds and mesquite.
Yeah.
So they're very unique,
but
simple. There's not a list of 25 things. They each have 6 to 8 ingredients.
Okay.
That's it, including the protein as the base.
Right.
And it's really clean. And I use them every day in smoothies. If I'm making like a matcha latte, I'll add the green one. If I'm making a coffee drink, I'll add the cacao one, because then the protein helps balance out the the spike in caffeine.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And after the protein and powders, I then went, I was like, oh, I need more of like a functional food, something right. that I can just grab and go. When I'm with the kids, I grab a jar of this and just go.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of like nut butters out there. So I wanted to do something a little more unique.
Okay.
And for when my kids were babies, I would give them coconut butter because before they can have nuts, they can have coconuts.
So, yes, yes.
You know, you're not supposed to introduce nuts till later on.
Right,
every parent's different in that, but I didn't introduce it till about 10 or 12 months. So before that, I was just giving them coconut meat. And then sometimes I would take the coconut meat and mix it with, to basically make my own coconut butter.
Right.
Yeah. And I would add my superfoods to it.
Yeah.
And blend it in a food processor and feed that to them.
Yeah.
Oh, and they loved it.
Oh,
enough of it. And like that genuine, like, need for something when babies are like craving something that's so good for them, you know that there's something good there.
Yeah,
so I think it was the good healthy fats. I think it was like the unique flavor profile. It tastes almost like frosting a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely.
So yeah, so that was the next product line.
That's
was
cool.
Like a functional food. So we have three different coconut butters, one in each flavor. You can melt it and spread it on toast.
Oh
yeah, a smoothie. You can eat it by the spoonful.
Right,
you can drizzle it on. You can melt it and put it on ice cream as like a shell.
Oh man, I'm getting hungry right now.
Yeah, I love that. Yeah, that's awesome. The best. It's the best. And then we have the honeys, which are organic honey.
Okay. Yeah.
They used to be Manuka honeys.
Okay.
But there's such a hard, like the demand is so challenging getting it from New Zealand.
Okay.
I used to. I was paying like 9 times the price.
Oh gosh.
To get it. And I was like, this isn't sustainable.
Right.
So now I get it from Topanga.
Yeah.
From
okay.
Organic local bee farm. It's organic.
Sure.
It's
food.
And I add the superfoods to that honey. So that's really great and medicinal and great on an empty stomach.
Yeah,
it's got lots of minerals and just all the benefits of amazing raw honey.
Right. Yeah. And the things that we lack and, you know, minerals and all the things we don't get in our diet. Yeah.
Exactly. Exactly. Awesome. Yeah. So that's kind of like the short end of all my product lines. Mm-hmm. And then from that, we use kind of those products to create the food-based cleanse. And
Okay.
The food-based cleanses, they're do-it-yourself cleanses, DIY, do-it-yourself, 5-day and 14-day. And then we also have a 1-day cleanse on there.
Okay.
We're going to start to add on a couple more, a 3-day and a 7-day. But for now, we have the 5-day and the 14-day. And they're really great. They teach you just 99% of people when they're done the food-based cleanses are like, couldn't I eat this way all the time? And I'm like,
Yep.
You can. You know, like,
it's really good for you and it tastes good. And it
it's not extreme. It's a breakfast, lunch, dinner, 2 snacks.
Yeah.
Like more than most people eat in a day. Like I've had models and like superstars do my cleanses and they're like, I'm so full. I don't even want to eat my snack right now. I'm like, eat it. No, you don't have to, you know, you want to listen to your body, it's weird for people to eat that much and like to get so many nutrients and so much fiber and so many like real whole foods.
Right.
Our bodies aren't used to that.
Right.
Most people aren't used to that.
Right. And they're not hungry because they are satisfied.
They're satisfied nutritionally. So they need less calories, but they have so much more nutrient density that their body is satisfied.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
That is awesome. So I love the products are great.
Yeah.
The cleanse idea is fantastic and that sets the tone for people. Now, if you're talking as a busy person, you know, and you know this, cause you're busy and you got a lot going on. And if you could give somebody one piece of advice to say, okay, they're busy, but they want to start, on a path towards health. Mm-hmm. What would that advice be?
I'd say start with one small change nutritionally. So let's say you don't eat breakfast right now. I'd say just add in a breakfast.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be overwhelming. It doesn't have to be like, oh, I'm going to make a green smoothie every morning. It doesn't have to be that.
Right.
Just one small change.
Yeah.
So say you don't eat breakfast, your difference will be eating breakfast.
Right, right.
And just make it a whole food. It can be eggs. It can be a piece of toast. It can be anything.
Right.
But that is going to jumpstart your metabolism.
Right.
Say that you do eat breakfast, but it's always like a banana smoothie and it's like a lot of sugar all at once.
Right.
Great. Now just add 2 handfuls of spinach to that.
Right.
That's it. You're making the same smoothie. Yeah. It won't change the flavor. So just little tiny things. And you know what you need. Just like in your workouts, in your everyday life, in your yoga, you know what your edge is.
Yeah.
You know what you need. You know when you need to like be stronger or be like back off a little bit.
Right.
Like I know where I lack. And usually I know exactly where to go. Like, I'm feeling a little heavy this week and lethargic. Oh, I have had dessert every night this week.
Right.
Yeah. Maybe I should cut that out.
Right.
Immediately it makes a change. I feel better. My tummy's flatter. I wake up with more energy. I'm not as lethargic. we all know. Really just think about it. Like, well, I have been skipping lunch every day this week. Maybe I should add something in there.
Yeah.
Boom.
Yeah.
You know, or I'm starting my day every day with sugar. I'm getting like white bread every morning. Okay, well, swap that out for like a high fiber gluten-free toast.
And right, something,
a taste that you love. You know, little, just one swap out.
Right.
And that little swap can make such a difference. Or, you know, not even, none of those had to do with my product lines, but like, say you make a smoothie every day, but there's no superfoods added. Or no protein. Sure.
Yeah.
Just buy one of my bags of food,
right?
Superfoods, and just add one tablespoon. It won't change the flavor. Yeah. You know, it's the same idea. And it's like, then you're getting all the nutrients you need for the day in one tablespoon.
Yeah. And that's awesome, because that's, everybody can do it. There's no excuse. You can, you can make one small change, whether it's diet, exercise, anything in your life. You can.
Exactly. If you're stagnant, it doesn't even have to be nutritional.
Yeah.
Say that every night before bed, you're looking at your phone until the minute you fall over. Right. Like, that's not good. That's, you know that. Yeah. And you know that because you have a headache and you're not sleeping well and you're getting weak. Like, we all know we are our own greatest guru and teacher. You just have to tune into that and start to be aware. Write down how you're feeling. Write down where you're lacking, you know, and it'll come through.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Well, Sophie, I can't thank you enough. This was fantastic. I love what you do. Fun. I love your history, your story. Aww. And I really thank you for your time
today.
This
was an honor. Thank you. I can't wait to watch it.
You're welcome. I'll let you know.
Yay. Thank you. Take care.
Bye-bye.